This city's awake. It's always awake. Never wanting to sleep. It's an everlasting heartbeat that yearns for attention. I'm the blood that runs through it. What keeps it flowing. They call me Crimson. Stand amongst these people, the poor, the defenseless, the people who just sit here and watch as the city collapses right before their eyes. But they understand it. They get it. The very people that stood there and promised to be by their side. The very vigilant police force that is out there. And yet, they failed these helpless people. In blue can't solve it, when they can't trust each other, they call in the man in red to figure it all out, just like now. Not all cops are bad. Some can be good if they try hard. Detective Ashley Gomez is a prime example. A good detective, a little naive, but I sense a bright future if she has the right attitude. And that's if she wants to have the right attitude.
Glad you're here tonight.
Another mugging through Gateway's crooked alleys, I presume.
Homicide up in Strawberry. Still look like I'm joking.
Tell me more.
Victim, 23, female.
And?
Anna Harrison, bludgeoned to death. No family, no other aliases, known occupation was history of prostitution. When we ID'd the victim, we found several other offenses from her record too.
Why do you need me?
Within 24 hours of me investigating, the case was pulled from me. When I asked around, I had a lead on where she had stayed. Right when I'm about to go there, dispatch informed me they needed me back at the station.
Sounds like a cover-up.
Is that like your thing? Believing that we're just all bad, huh?
I wouldn't think that had it not been for the 46% rise in crime recently in the past 8 months. I think it's safe to assume either the cops don't know how to do their job, or they're just as corrupt as the criminals they claim to protect.
Are you going to help me?
I'll help you. But I need you to be open-minded here at the idea that it isn't every day a cold case is pulled from a detective within 48 hours and still have a job. Address.
She lives in those apartments over there where the ball is hanging nowadays. Apartment B24.
I'll let you know when I have more info.
called me over because you needed to talk.
Good to see another fellow officer of the law. The cops won't suspect a thing anymore, Max.
Then that means we're through here, right?
You've done your bidding, it seems. Not quite. Anna was talking to a reporter. I don't know who, but I need you to find him.
A reporter? You want me to kill him too? Look, I'm sorry to break this to you, but I'm about fed up with your bullshit. I'm not your fucking lackey, okay? I did my part. How about you do your-
Let's get this straight, Max. I give you a chance at prying away at all your dirty little secrets sprinkled through the city, and you decide to just say no? Hypocritical, it seems. I tell you no. Until then, if you want your good name to remain unchecked, then I suggest you find the reporter, whatever information he knows, and make sure it's silenced. I will be watching you.
First off, I want to send my condolences, but two nights ago your roommate Anna Henderson was bludgeoned to death. I'd like to ask some questions pertaining to her murder.
What? She's dead? What do you want to know?
I have reason to suspect she may have been mixed up with the wrong people. What do you know about her?
There isn't much I can tell you. She works at night and sleeps during the day.
Listen to me very carefully. A murder of a young woman occurred two nights ago. A woman who was young. Like you. I find it hard to believe both of you never spoke at least once. She works at night, sleeps during the day. Doesn't really help now, does it?
Look, you don't have to be an asshole about it, buddy.
No, but I'm not the one to beat around the bush. Now talk.
I'm not gonna talk to the cops. But I'll tell you. But whatever I tell you doesn't leave this room. Like 2 weeks ago, Anna came home early, which she doesn't usually do. She told me she had made all the money she needed for that night.
Anything prior to the murder where she may have acted unusual?
She kept telling me about an extremely wealthy guy that pays real good money. Well, one night she came home just terrified out of her mind. She told me when she got there, she walked in on his body and he was dead. Then what creeped her out and made her leave was this man.
A man?
She said he had this weird owl mask. Afterwards, some guy kept coming over. Nice guy, he didn't seem like he was a threat to her. Wore like a red jacket.
An owl. Very odd. Any idea who this guy might be?
I don't. I'm sorry.
I know you said you didn't want to tell anybody what you told me. I hope after tonight, that's still true.
Oh, I'm leaving Gateway City.
That would be the smartest decision of your life.
An owl? What the fuck?
That's what I was thinking. But something tells me there's more to this owl.
It's odd there hasn't been any reported news of any extremely wealthy men being murdered. You'd think the press would be all over it by now.
Maybe that's what the reporter was gonna find out more on.
I say we find him. He's gotta have leads.
He's gotta. Any reporter you know like to wear a red jacket?
Roland Parker. Guy likes to snoop on any possible leads, but he's like you with a reckless attitude.
I'll track him down.
Why do you do what you do? I don't get it.
Because I don't believe a town as dangerous as Gateway City has an actual trustable police force. Given the fact that you ask me says a lot about your trust and even your own.
You know, even though I'm trusting you with this, those people you're talking about are like my family. Gateway sucks, but I'd appreciate if you'd lay off the conspiracy bullshit.
You know damn well what your brothers are capable of.
What the fuck is your problem with cops? I came to you because I believed we could solve this, not because I wanted to set you up for some bullshit. You're just paranoid. Get it together.
What? No, I'm off right now. The Harrison case should be closed. No one should be... What did you say? Wait, how can that be? Fine. I'll go there and check it out. Tell Rich to meet me at the conference area. Yeah, thanks. Called me over?
Hey, Edison, how you doing?
Just another night. Can't complain. So, do you mind telling me why it needed to be called over for a case that's won and done with?
You ain't gonna believe this, but some biker showed up wanting to speak with you. Something about the girl Anna Harrison. I don't know why, but they want you to meet at Heaven's Gate.
You guys have a good night. Who are you and why the fuck are you tailing me?
Relax. I'm on your side.
Yeah? How so?
Because I know a man in a black jacket is searching for you. My guess? He killed Anna. I want to know why.
There isn't a rich, wealthy man.
What?
Cross-referenced several names. All from different cities, different salaries. She was dealing with some high-profile men. But not who you think. I did more digging, only to find out the man she claims was killed was George Walton. Mr. Walton is a cop.
God damn it, I fucking knew it. This case just gets stranger by each clue. Did Anna tell you where she slept with this man? A location?
You ever heard of Heaven's Gates Club?
Motorcycle gang? I know where.
Want my advice? Get out of Gateway City as fast as you can.
Unfortunately, this isn't something I could just back myself out of. However, you should leave.
Hey, what do they call you?
Crimson. The Lost. A shithead-infested biker gang full of degenerate scum who like to prey on the weak. Lately, their operations have died down over the years. No reason why. Maybe new players have hit the streets. Maybe because I'm hoping for their downfall. Either way, I don't put it past to the boys in blue slowly. It's starting to feel like a case of abuse of power. Excuse me, I'd like to ask you all some questions. Which one of you fucking scumbags know anything about Anna Harrison? Looks like I got your attention.
Whatever girl you talk about sure ain't been here. But if you got a problem, Red Man, I suggest you fuck off before I break your...
Hey, yo, get that crimson fucker!
You take one step closer and I'll blow your fucking head off, man.
Shitheads.
I swear, I don't know what you're talking about.
I heard different.
They're lying to you. I don't know anything about no girl named fucking Anna.
Lying again.
What makes you think I'm lying? Other than just part of me being a criminal.
I'm gonna tell you what I know.
Come on, man. I got the money. You want the money? I can give you 5K easy. Just let me go.
I know George Walton was there. I know he had a little fun with the prostitute when he was there. Now, if you want your bones still intact at her sockets, unlike your friends back at your joint, I suggest you talk. Talk!
Okay, fine. A couple cops show up on a regular basis. We run a legit service, you know? Whenever cops need some downtime from their lives, we offer them some females to them as a sign of loyalty and respect, you know? Please, I don't get involved with this.
You don't get involved, but you sure as hell know what goes on in there.
If I tell you, it's going to kill me. I only seen it a couple times. And some of the other guy, I don't know
who. Who was with George?
Tell you, it's going to kill me. I only seen it a couple of times. Some other guy, I don't know who.
You're just fucking useless to me, it seems. Have a nice time trying to get
Wait,
down.
No, I'll tell you, it's a guy named Max. Max Edison. He came in with the owl with Anna. Max came in before you showed up looking for Ronald Parker, one of our guys who lived in here since he did a story on his way back. That's all I fucking know, man, I swear.
Shit, the reporter.
Wait up, wait!
For some reason, this officer looked at me in a way that said, guilt. I know that look. Oh, while I looked at him and realized this man was all along hidden right beneath the shade of blue. This man was Max Edison. And soon, he's gonna be mine. Anna Harrison isn't my first case. She's a dime a dozen. A woman I have no idea who she looks like, what she stood for, or even if she was my enemy. It's a tragedy when a life is flushed down the streets. It's not my job to protect them. Some days, I think of a man named Danny Burton. He was a man in blue. A man who believed in self-sacrifice. He knew the line between right and wrong, good and evil. At the end of the day, his demise came at a cost. A lost soul abandoned within the depths of Gateway's underbelly. At the end, I think of his last moments. As if I was there. One day, I'll know about Danny Burton. But it's not the color blue it calls for tonight. It calls for the man in red.
Hey, Johnny, how you doing?
20 on pump, 2 regular, 2 packs of smoke, and that's it. This is Max.
Hello, Max. You're probably wondering why I'm calling you, seeing as one of your little biker boys already ratted you out.
Who is this?
A man who knows why you killed Anna Harrison. And I know why you and your little owl friend do this for a living. I say you come clean.
Oh, yeah.
You probably won't.
Then who the fuck do you think you are accusing me?
I think I'm someone that can easily break you mentally and physically. Unless you want Weasel News to run a story on corrupt officer Max Edison, you come empty-handed, and we settle this.
Where?
Meet me by the meatpacking place across the street in the alley.
Yeah.
Max. Let's talk!
Who the fuck are you? Oh shit!
The owl, speak! Fucking run.
I need your help.
Help? Why?
Listen, I've stuck my ass out for you and your little operation. I can use some fucking help here, man.
Yes, to which you didn't even clean up properly.
You gotta be joking.
You'll tell him everything while I go ahead and let the evening news know that you not only killed two civilians, but I'm sure they wouldn't mind to know why child pornography photos appeared on your work desktop.
No, fuck you. I'll tell him everything.
It takes one phone call, Max. One phone call to ruin your reputation.
Oh, go to hell!
The best thing for you to do, Max, is jump.
Hello there, Max. This stops.
Fuck you!
Enough! Tell me now! Who is it, the owl?
Fuck off. I've had it with this. All of it!
Why did he want you to kill Anna?
You can't stop this.
Maybe. But if you tell me, I know I can try.
Why should I tell you?
I know a lot of cops like you who fall prey to the idea of having it all. Reaping the riches for some undeserved benefit you feel entitled to. You were better than that, Max. You don't have to do it anymore.
Big Brother watches from upstairs.
Just like that, I was left with another big mystery in my life. Wondering who I am, and wondering who this owl man is. Wondering whether or not the lives of three civilians, Anna Harrison, Roland Parker, and Max Edison meant anything to the city as it all remains quiet, consumed into the darkness. So long, Max.
What do you want?
It's been 24 hours since I delivered your case. You wanted my help, so I delivered.
Yeah, and? Do you want a fucking medal?
You speak as if this is my fault that he leaped himself off the damn
roof. Another dead body, not to mention an officer of the law on top of it.
I told you, it was Max, your fellow crooked officer who failed your badge and aligned himself with this fucking owl.
The owl? Do you hear yourself? You talk about this mythical criminal, yet all three of the victims who told you about this are all now dead. Great detective work, really proud.
While I admit, these past couple of nights were hectic, you can't just say none of this seems at all off to you. A prostitute, a reporter, a cop, all wind up dead, and all within the same time frame, all while the owl's hands are all wiped clean. You didn't even trace the fucking phone records of your own goddamn officer who committed suicide.
Get out!
Don't worry, I'll be around when you pigs need to fill a fucking quota.
Get out!
The city is awake. It's always awake. Like this city, I'll stay awake. The murder of Anna Harrison might have ran cold with the cops. Not with me. I know who's responsible. Day by day, I'll search for this owl. Until then, Max Edison has left an impression on the self-righteous blue-collar protectors. Now I'm their enemy. The feeling's mutual. Until then, like the city, I'll stay awake.
It's done. He's not going to be bothering me anymore.
Good. Good.
He kept bringing up the owl again. He's dead set on taking you down. We're done here though, right?
I'll warn you one last time, Gomez. It's never finished. It's finished when I say it's finished. The city is about to change. Enjoy it while it lasts. Ha 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 ha